At this time, I am pleased to introduce one such outstanding individual, our honored alumni speaker, Professor So Win Mint, professor in the School of Geographical Sciences and Urban Planning and senior sustainability scientist in the Global Institute of Sustainability at Arizona State University, USA. Professor Mint obtained his BS in forestry from Rangoon University, Myanmar, postgraduate diploma in forest survey from the International Institute for Aerospace Survey and Earth Sciences in the Netherlands in 1989, MSc in Natural Resources Program at the Asian Institute of Technology in 1994, and a PhD in Geography in GI Science from Louisiana State University, USA in 2001. He was a research specialist at the United Nations Environment Program, the Environment Assessment Program for Asia and the Pacific. He worked at the University of Oklahoma, and since 2005, he is at the Arizona State University. He was also a consultant at the World Health Organization in Geneva, Switzerland. Professor Mint is a distinguished teacher and researcher and has received a number of awards, and I cite a few. Outstanding Achievement Award from the American Association of Geographers of the Remote Sensing Specialty Group. Prominent Alumnus Recognition and AIATA Distinguished Alumni Award for Academic and Research Excellence. More than 10 Best Paper, Best Student Awards. USGS Scholar Award at the first International Conference on GI Science. He has published more than 125 articles and books and a H-index of 31. He has served as President, Vice President, Membership Chair, and Director of the American Society of Photogrammetry and Remote Sensing of the Southwest US region. He has also served as Chair, Vice Chair, and Director of the American Association of Geographers Remote Sensing Specialty Group. He has been serving as Subject Editor of Ecosystem Health and Sustainability Journal and as Associate Editor of Remote Sensing Journal. He serves on the editorial boards of GI Science and Remote Sensing and the International Journal of Remote Sensing. He is also a member of the NASA Land Covered Land Use Team. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back home to the Asian Institute of Technology our very own special alumni speaker, Professor So Win Mint.
Thank you for the introduction, Professor Kumar. Mr. President, Excellencies, Board of Trustees, distinguished guests, and faculty members, families and friends, and most importantly, the graduates. It is truly a great honor for me to be here and talk to you all at this special occasion. You know, it brings my memory back. I was here sitting in the same room on my graduation day. I was sitting around here and I was so excited. I was very, very happy. It was one of the best days in my entire life. It was truly a wonderful day. This particular graduation looks exactly the same as the one I attended like 25 years ago. The only difference is that I'm almost bald now. That's the only difference. Well, that's not the reason why I'm wearing graduation cap. But seriously, I know exactly how you all have worked. You all have worked very hard. You all have worked very seriously, diligently. You all have worked days and nights. I understand the level of pressure to study here at AIT. So that is the good thing. You all deserve this. You will have a great future ahead. So big congratulations to you all. I really would like to take this opportunity to share two short stories with you. I hope you like stories. The first story took place at Stanford University in the 1960s. A professor in psychology and his research team members conducted an experiment, what is now known as marshmallow test, which is also known as don't eat marshmallow yet. The experiment is basically designed to evaluate one's ability to delay gratification or delay temptation, which is also a test to the level of your self control and willpower, which is linked to your success. And so here is how it goes. The professor and his team members bring in 1 4-year-old kid and let him or her sit at a table and put a marshmallow in front of the kid. And they tell that this marshmallow belongs to you. You can eat anytime you like. We're leaving the room now, but we will be back in 15 minutes. If you don't eat marshmallow in 15 minutes, you will get another marshmallow. If you would like to eat anytime, just ring the bell. We'll be back. And they leave the room. They do the same test to all kids, and they found out that most of the kids eat marshmallow in less than 3 minutes. Some of them actually eat right away. As soon as the team leaves, they eat it. Some of them even don't care of ringing the bell. I don't have time to ring it, I'll just eat it now. Right? So I have seen a similar study where they put the video cameras. Some kids struggle really badly. They even don't want to look at the, they try so hard not to look at the marshmallow. Some of them look at the ceiling, look at the floor and look different direction. When they look at the marshmallow, they breathe so hard. And some of them touch it and breathe hard. Some of them took the marshmallow, sniff it and put it back. They try so hard. Now, one particular girl basically sniffed it like this for so many times before she put it back. And one of the girls basically opened the marshmallow from the bottom and took the middle part and ate it and put it back as if she didn't do it. So only about 30% of the kids were able to control for 15 minutes and got another marshmallow. So many years later, the professor and his team members found out that those kids who ate marshmallow really quick were not successful in their lives. They dropped out of high school. They dropped out of colleges. They had a lot of social problems. They became drug addicts. And they don't have friends, or they have only a few friends. They don't know how to handle things in a very difficult situations or stressful situations. You know, those kids who were able to control for 15 minutes and got another marshmallow, they all were successful. Let me give you an example. Those kids who ate marshmallow in less than 3 minutes got an average SAT score 210 points lower than those kids who were able to control for 15 minutes. I hope you get my, you know, message. Don't eat marshmallow yet. This applies to anybody at any age. It doesn't matter whether you are 21 years old or 38 years old or 59 years old or 75 years old. If you have a dream, if you have a goal, if you want to achieve something, don't eat marshmallow yet. Right? So let me move on to the second one. It's also a short one. This one also involves a professor. Where you all might be thinking that this speaker loves professor stories because he is a professor. No, it's not true. It's just a coincidence. So this professor is in philosophy. I don't know his university. He brought a transparent jar to his class one day, and he put 2-inch-sized rocks and keep filling until no more rocks can be added, and he asked the class, is that full now? And they say, yes, it is full. Then he adds some small pebbles and shake the jar and let those small pebbles go through all these gaps and keep adding until no more pebbles can be added. He asks, is this full now? And the class says, yes, it is full. Then he pours some sand and keep adding sand until no more sand can be added. And he raised the same questions. The class answered the same. Then he pours water and then keep adding water until no more water can be added. And he asks the same questions. The class says, yes, it is really full now. Then he says, the jar, rocks, pebbles, sand, and water are like your life. Those rocks are the most important items in your life. For example, your family, your children, your spouse, your parents, your goal, and your health. Pebbles are like your job and your house, your cars, and your friends. Then professor says, if you don't have pebbles, if as long as you have those rocks, your life is still full. You are still okay. sand and water are like other activities. For example, watching movies or watching sports or watching entertainment, watching news, and going out for a picnic or vacation on a beach or camping in a wilderness or throwing parties in your backyard, hanging out with friends at pubs and clubs and bars and restaurants. Then Professor says, imagine if you put your jar with sand and water first, you don't have space for your rocks and pebbles. Those rocks are the most important item. Pebbles are the second most important item, so you need to be careful. That's what the professor says. Let me give you some examples with regards to rocks. You will need to spend time with your family. You may need to consider playing with your kids if you have children. You need to spend time with your spouse and your parents. Or you may need to consider doing yoga and meditation for your health. You will need to allocate some time for your regular medical checkup for your health. Or you may need to consider physical exercise half an hour a day for at least 3-4 days a week. That will make you fit. That will make you live longer. That will get rid of the disease or minimize all these health issues. These are rocks, the most important items. With regards to rocks, let's think about our parents. These are solid rocks. When I say parents, that basically includes biological parents, adoptive parents, foster parents, guardians, and all other people who have been taking care of you. Let's think about that. Our parents provide us a place to live. Our parents provide us a place to eat. Our parents provide us a place to sleep. Our parents provide us a place to study. Our parents provide us a place to play. They provide us a place to take shower. They provide us a place to do whatever toilet-related things. They provide us lights, water, foods, clothes, shoes and sandals and everything. That's some items are like every day, every minute, every second that they provide. They always would like us to be successful. They always listen to us. They give us suggestions and advice for overall well-being of us. They would like us to see. They would like us to be successful. They would like us to be healthy and happy. If we are successful, they are happy. If we are happy, they are happy. If we fail, they're upset. They might be upset more than us. When you fail, you may not see tears in their eyes. They're crying here. Right? Some of you, our parents may come back and be on your side. Don't worry, it is nothing. It's not the end of the world. We are on your side. You will be fine. Don't be upset, things like that. Some parents may not say that, but it is still crying here, right? So you need to consider our parents. Try to return whenever possible, whatever is possible. It doesn't have to be expensive. When you call them, say hello to them, how are you? Use Viber or Skype or Facebook Messenger, anything. Send a text message or send an email. Make sure that they're happy. They're pleased. Don't make them upset, right? Let's say, you know, you don't have to do expensive thing. If they love apples, buy apples with your salary and bring it for them. Trust me, you'll get tremendous blessings and good deeds. If you are very rich and you donate $1 million to a charity, that could be HIV patients or AIDS patients or elderly people or disabled people or cancer patients, you get tremendous blessings. When you bring that 5 apples for your parents who has been always helping you and devoted their entire life for you, they are the only 2 people on earth with unconditional love for us, right? So we need to think about that. So return whatever you can for your parents. But in general, as a, you know, academic brother, I also would like to suggest that please be kind to another, be sincere and nice, be honest, don't tell a lie, don't bully other people to be successful. Don't exploit other people to be successful. Don't be tricky. Don't be crooked, right? So you will be fine. You'll just be successful. Just keep doing what you are doing. And in general, you know, if we do bad things, we get bad things. If we do good things, we get good things. It's a universal truth. It's nothing to do with our religion. So we don't want to do that, right? So I think my time is up, so let me wrap it up. Don't eat marshmallow yet. Give priority to your rocks and pebbles. Take care of your parents. Be kind and nice and sincere. And then don't create any problems to anybody for any reason. Treat others as you would like to be treated. Right? So this is the time for you to shine. Again, you will have a great future ahead. Big congratulations. Thank you.